Good day, my people. It's your coach PK coming at you live from a place of comfort. I'm just on my way to MSEC to referee another round of domestic competition. So, very excited, always happy to come to MSEC and get a bit more games under my belt and also be able to help other young new referees coming up so they can also get better with their refereeing. I believe I've got two A-grade games, so which is good because it's gonna be with somebody that is new into the A-grade world, and super excited to mentor another upcoming referee. So super good. Anyway, this is just a quick video that I was gonna do because it only takes about 10 minutes to walk from my car where I parked down here to the actually basketball courts and stadium. So it's a quick video that I thought I would just come in and speak to you guys and you know, make sure that we are all on the same page, you know what I mean? Anyway, this video I was gonna talk about how I end up in Australia. So as you are aware, I was born in a country called Africa, in a continent called Africa, in a country called Angola. So all the way back here in Africa. So I moved out of the country when I was about 14 years old. Not many people are aware, but some countries, including Angola, where I was born, is a country that to serve the army is compulsory. So I didn't want to go to the army. So my parents and my uncles and aunties, they all put money together and they sent me to Germany. So I did live in Germany for 6 years, from the time I was 14 to the time I was about 20, 22. From there, I moved to start playing basketball in Germany in a team called Telekom Baskets. And from there, I went to play from the same sponsor, which is Telekom, but in Portugal. So I went to play in Portugal for about 3 years. And that's when the Olympic Games in Sydney came up and I discovered Australia. Before the Olympic Games, only thing that we saw on TV living in Europe was either kangaroos or emus jumping and attacking people. And that's all we knew about Australia. We didn't know much about. We didn't even know Russell Crowe and Nicole Kidman were Australians. We just assumed they were Americans. And when they start advertising things on TV and showing the Sydney Harbour Bridge and all the beautiful buildings and beautiful people they live here and were living in Australia back in those days, that's when we decided in January 13, 2001 to come and visit Australia. So that was myself and my older brother. So just the two of us jump on the plane, got a visiting visa, and we came in. So once we arrived in Australia, we came from winter. We arrived in Australia, it was summer. It was beautiful. The people were lovely. You know, the buildings, the houses, the cars were great. And we never left. So yeah, once you found a place you feel at home, once you found a place where you feel like you're comfortable, why leave? So we never left, we stayed, and we have been here since. So it's been now 23 years. Since I have been living in Australia, I found basketball again, discovered basketball again, had a daughter, and so I'm living a happy life here in Australia. Now going back to Europe, unless I'm going to visit my relatives or my nephews and nieces, they are still living up there, or in a case, I'm going to visit, you know, spend a bit of holidays over in Europe. Now, just about to arrive at MSEC here, and like I say, another night of refereeing, looking forward to another wonderful, beautiful games. So I thought I'll share this story with you guys, how I ended up in Australia. Hopefully it was interesting. Sorry I don't have much. Well, I could go into more details and go a little bit deep on what exactly, you know, step by step on how to get here, how to fly here, how to get a visa, I could get into more in-depth details, but I thought I'll leave it for another video that was going to be a longer video, so I've got more time at the moment I've got about, like I say, 10 minutes or so to walk all the way to MSEC, to the referee's room, get changed, and start refereeing another, I think it's 5 games tonight of domestics. I hope it was interesting. If it was, give me a thumbs like, you know, like thumbs like, thumbs up. Also, yeah, so I apologize for this noise. So there's a couple of kids sort of just shooting the ball down there. And they are super, super loud. It looks like it was a party. Might have been a birthday party where they celebrated here. So there is a kindergarten just sort of there. And a lot of people hire these rooms to actually go and celebrate birthdays and parties. I hope you can hear me. It's super, super loud here with these youngsters. And I'm just entering MSEC now, getting closer to my games. And I can hear the balls bouncing. I see the people running and playing already from the distance. So it looks like it was some kind of a foodie event behind me here. I've got the whites and the blues. I'm assuming it might be something to do with maybe Carlton, maybe the Kangaroos even, because they are the white and blues. So if you're a foodie supporter within the Kangaroos, sort of North Melbourne, so they've had something here happening at MSEC, which was just fun for the kids. It looks like it. Anyway, I'm just about to enter the stadium now, so I apologize if it gets too loud. I hope, hey, how are you? And hey, how are you? I apologize if it gets too loud. Georgie! So I've been here for a long time, so I know a lot of people. Anyway, yeah, so I was walking into the stadium now to, as you can see, there's a green shirt refereeing on his court here. And on his here, there's some women games happening. It looks like a call has been made. It was the right call. I didn't see it, but I just trust the referee making the right call. And I'm going to go and say it was the right call. All right, so yeah, well, when I used to play, I never actually noticed the referee. I was happily surprised when they called a foul for me, because I wasn't going to stop anyway. I was playing, I was continuous playing. I don't know about you guys. Do you always get surprised when there is a call, or do you just don't care? I just never cared. Like I said, I was definitely surprised when I got a call for me and just accepted whenever the call wasn't against me. The referees are human, they make errors. I am a human, I make errors. So I can't expect them to get it all right. And they don't. And I just play on. It's about me playing and they're fine. Not about winning or anything. So I'm just holding off here because there's an offense happening on this end. And I don't want to be in the middle of the offense. There you go. It looks like it's 2 points for the black team. Would you count it? I think it was a 2 points for the black team. Well done. And now carrying on here, just walking off and watching this beautiful MSEC stadium. Sorry, my camera is not as wide, but I think you can see from the background how big MSEC actually is. I had to put it a little bit a cropped sort of thing just because I did not want to be able to help with the stabilization. So if it's not cropped much, there is less stabilization and too much shaking. I didn't want you to be looking at me and seeing me shaking. I thought I'll make it a little bit less shakier. So behind me is just the ref's room there. I'm about to get in there. And while I'm in there, I'm not gonna be able to record as I'm gonna get changed and get ready for another round of basketball refereeing. So just sharing some more images with you guys. So there's a court there, there's court 2, court 4, and at the back there's court 6 and 8. Over the other side is 1, 3, 5 and 7. And even further on the other side is the what we call the arena. And the arena has got 2 more courts. So it's 10 courts all up. And I think there's another table tennis courts at the back, which you can transform it into another 4 courts if you really wanted to. And you needed the numbers. I hope this video has been entertaining, you know, just in the process of getting to know each other. Your coach PK. And before you go away, just make sure you also watch this video over here and this video over here. And in the middle where my face is, click on it, click on the subscribe button and click on the notification bell so you don't miss my very next video. Tschüssi.